I know what you're going to ask.
Yeah.
Can I predict?
Yeah.
You'd like to sleep with me.
Oh, how did you know? I quite like your teeth.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm pleased that out of the entire body that I have, my teeth are the things that
very
do
nice
it for
teeth.
You.
But really, what I was going to ask you was obviously, you are the man to ask, and just a really honest opinion. If you have heard, because I don't know if you've heard any of my songs or anything, though.
I haven't heard your songs, but I think you're very lucky because there are a lot of performers out there who don't write their own stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And there are a lot of writers who can't perform. And at the moment, you have the ability to do both. If one goes tits up, you've got the other.
Yeah.
And if both go tits up...
Then I'll be a...
You're screwed.
Cool girl.
Yeah.
Okay.
Good luck with that. I tell you what, if things get that bad, I'll hire you.
Oh, thank you. You can
just
make some coffee.
Just to come round and chat.
Yeah.
You know, nothing mucky.
9:36 p.m. Latoya, Jeremy, Amelia and Victor are by the hot tub.
Not just Barbies.
Really? Oh, I'd love to do Barbie.
What? You'd love to have huge fake tits?
Yeah.
And long hair. That's disgusting.
She said her life's ambition is to get big breasts.
No, don't get it.
You look fantastic.
People can die from that.
Don't change it, seriously.
No, is that even serious?
Yeah, be serious. Don't change it, seriously.
Jeremy thinks me looks fantastic.
Yeah, well she does.
Earlier today, celebrity hijacker Chris Moyles set the housemates a pub quiz. John was the winner, and as a reward, Chris gave him a mobile phone with 3 minutes of call time. John decided to share his call time with Anthony, who spoke to his mum.
Hang on a minute.
Oh, long time. I haven't been here for 10 days. What day is it? Day 11?
And it's going to be over soon.
Ready for the jingle, bitch?
Could Anthony...
Yay!
Yay! Right, let's try and make him cry. In a happy way. In a happy way.
How's his mum?
Hello.
Hello, Anthony.
How you doing, mate? All right?
I'm great, man. I'm very good. How are you?
I feel really good at the minute. I feel such a massive high. So, and I just rang my mum and said I really needed that. So, he touched me.
How close are you to your mum, Anthony?
She's like my favourite person in the whole world. As a family, like me, my mum and my four sisters, you know, we're really tight, like watertight. And, yeah, there's nothing more in the world means, like, more to me than them.
I think there'll be a very proud mum somewhere crying for her son with tears of joy. And I bet she's absolutely delighted to speak to you. And I bet she loves you very much and misses you. Cry! In the calmness of the diary room, what would you like to say to your mum and the rest of your family?
Just hoping that they're okay and everyone's safe and everyone's fine and happy and...
Cry, you fuck.
And hoping that they miss me as well. Hoping they miss me as much as I miss them.
You soppy fucker. I wanted you in blubs and tears, but you know what? I couldn't do it to you. You're too much of a top fella.
Cheers, thank you.
Listen, don't feel upset. Feel very happy you spoke to her. Now listen, well done. Your mum and your family are proud. Boo fucking who. Get back in the house and have some fun.
Cheers, will do. Thank you.
And Anthony.
Mm-hmm.
See you in Vegas, dude.
Yeah, we'll do. Definitely. Hopefully see you before that anyway.
You're on.
But you'll see me there anyway. Cheers. Thank
you.
Take care, mate.
All right, bye, man.
Bye-bye.
12:49 a.m. It's been 2 hours and 44 minutes since Chris Moyles' celebrity hijack ended. 1 hour and 2 minutes ago, Nathan told Amy he fancied her. Amelia, Amy, Nathan and Jeremy are in the bathroom.
Nathan, I'm really shy and embarrassed and I really don't know what to say.
Oh, gosh.
Do you like Amy, Nathan?
Out of what? All of the people that you would have said that to, it'd handle these things the worst, without a shadow of a doubt.
That's why I said you.
Yeah, so like embarrass Amy. Me.
What? Yeah. Do you think I was making a move on you? I wasn't making a move on you, babe. I wanted to make you aware. I don't even know why I done it now. I apologise. Because it wasn't like, oh, I have a crush on you, Amy. It wasn't. Honestly, I've done it to deflect the attention off me and Latoya because because it's stressing me out.
Are you just not interested at all?
No comment.
Liam, Victor and LaToya are in the bedroom.
In the real world, I have all these distractions, like girlfriends, work, money, play, parties or practicing, training. You know, everything gets in the way. As in here, I don't have any of these distractions, so it kind of opens up what I don't like, what I do like, what I feel like, what I'm tired, when I want to eat alone, when I want to be alone. You know, it opens up all these other doors.
Yeah.
And that's what I've had to face.
Anthony, John, Callista and Jir come to the diary room.
Yo, big bro.
Hey. How are we, housemates?
Yeah, really good.
We are. Big brother, can you just tell me if it's okay if I just sort of sit here or something?
Yay!
Can you see me, big brother?
That's great, John. I can see all of you now.
Okay.
Cool.
What more do you need?
Should you tell us an emotion and we'll portray it on our faces?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
To warm up.
Yeah, to warm up.
Let's warm up.
And then we're going to sing a song.
Because the first thing we need to do in this room is warm up.
Yeah.
Housemates, what emotion are you feeling at the moment?
Do you need to tell us?
No, you tell us an emotion and we'll do it.
You've got to get us into a false sense of
security. Could be anything. Yeah. Could be gleeful.
Could be
sheepish.
Petrified, sheepish. Fragmented.
Maybe if you express an emotion, Big Brother will guess your emotion.
Oh! Oh. Okay. Well, let's confirm.
I forgot.
Okay, ready? Up to three. One, two, three.
Ooh.
Hmm.
Oh, shit.
Big Brother thinks you may be pensive.
Yeah! Yeah. Well
done. Well, you're good.
Definitely.
Okay. 2:13 a.m. Some of the housemates are in the bedroom. Nathan is describing Anthony and Callista's relationship.
There's a scale, yeah? Like, starts with, like, hate. Hate's at that side. Love's at that side. Yeah? And then there's despise, I'd say. And then, you know, can't stand. And then can stand, tolerate, like, and all of that. You're in between, like, and infatuation.
Oh.
Wow, that's
doesn't see that one coming.
Didn't see that one on the scale.
How about that? That spiced up. Stir it up. Gee. Dun,
dun, dun, dun, dun, dun. You're all the way up to infatuation.
Victor and Jeremy are at the pub.
Aye. Man. Shit. It's been a few bullseyes there today. Most of them mine.
Amy is in the diary room.
Hello, Amy.
Hi. I had a slightly stressful evening. I was wondering if I could talk about it before I went to bed.
Of course, Amy. Big Brother's always here for you to talk.
Okay. Well, basically, Nathan said that he had a crush on me. To me, when everyone was there in the beds. And obviously, I thought that Nathan and LaToya were really kind of close and that they were going to sort of, I don't know, go out forever. Well, I was being slightly over-romantic, but we all thought that something was kind of going on and that they both really liked each other. And I know that LaToya really likes Nathan because it's really obvious. I thought that he was sort of taking the mick and then I kind of ignored it a bit. But then when he carried on talking about it and I realised that he wasn't actually joking, I don't think. But LaToya was stood right there and I think that she might have heard because now she's sleeping in the bed that's not next to my bed but the bed away from that. So not only is LaToya possibly upset if she heard what he said, but also now I feel like I've made the situation awkward or embarrassing for Nathan. It was a bit traumatic at the time. I just didn't know what to say. And it didn't... Oh, I'm just really rubbish at this kind of thing.
Tuesday, day 13, 11:08 p.m. 1 hour and 5 minutes ago, Jay and LaToya staged a fake argument. When they revealed that the argument wasn't real, Victor took offence at what they'd done and had a real argument with LaToya. Victor, Liam, Jeremy, Amelia and Amy are in the bedroom.
I'm not happy because I didn't want to be involved in their stupid joke, and then I did get involved in their stupid joke emotionally.